Hi everyone, welcome. I'm Esther Eckhart from EckhartYoga.com. This set of exercises takes your shoulders through their full range of movements. And there's two parts of the shoulders. There's the humerus bone, upper arm bone, and the scapula. So we use both. So the humerus makes certain movement like flexion, extension, etc. And the scapula makes certain movements. And I'll talk more in writing about that in the magazine. But for this video, we'll just go through all the ranges of movements of both parts that sort of makes up the shoulder. So the first one is you can interlace the fingers and exhalation, push the palms out, and on an inhalation, lift your arms up. And here you can feel the flexion of the humerus bone and the elevation of the scapula. And we can breathe here. So these are the first movements. So it's important regularly to take your shoulders through their full range of movement. And this is how you avoid injury. That's also really interesting to know. And usually within a yoga practice, I make sure all of these movements are somewhere incorporated. You can do them seated, standing. You can do them in a lunge, in a warrior. So you can be creative. Inhale, exhale gently, come down with the arms. And then you can take your arms out and up, and then we move from cactus arm. So here we're in abduction, and then you can bring your right elbow on top of the left. We move into adduction and palms touch. So it looks from the side, it looks like that. And here there is protraction of the scapula. So the scapula is being pulled apart, and external rotation of the humerus bones. So you can also just gently come in a little bit of a forward bend, and then there is a bit of a stretch between the shoulder blades. And the other thing I personally like doing is just circle around a little bit here. Just keep it fluid. Make sure it feels good. Okay, inhale, release the arms, bring them back into cactus, and then left arm on top. So you can come into that gentle forward bend. And as well, when you really slide the shoulder blades down, there's depression of the scapula, but that's being, yeah, basically. And okay, and then come back. And on an in-breath, release the arms back to cactus pose and releasing them down for a moment. And then we come to interlacing the fingers at the back. So what you're going to do is you're going to take the arms out and then turn the palms away and gently bring the fingers together. So if this is intense for you, it could be the way the bone structure is, the shoulder blades, that makes it impossible, then just use a belt so that you can quite easily and comfortably do this. So you can first bring the shoulders back, keep a little bend in the elbow, and then when it feels good, you can begin to extend the arms, straighten them out. Lift the collarbones and the sternum a little bit. Shoulder blades release down. So here again, there's depression of the scapula, because the shoulder blades release down. And there is downward rotation and external rotation happening. And the downward rotation is of the scapula, but it's being instigated through movement of the humerus bone. Feel it, inhale, and then gently release. And bring the arms back. And it, the effect of all these exercises, that there's such a lovely sort of energy moving through the shoulders. You can really feel the circulation. And then the next is where you can hold on to, I'll turn, you can hold on to the elbows or your lower arms like that. So now we get the retraction of the shoulder blade. So the shoulder blades are being pulled together. There's also internal rotation of the humerus bones, and there is downward rotation of the scapula as well. So this one, or if you prefer, you can bring the fingertips together and turn the fingertips up, and then bring the palms together in reverse namaste. So you can choose your variation. And just feel it here for a moment, just releasing the shoulder blades, not pushing them down, just releasing them. You can hear to practice what we learned about the neck and the technics. Just imagine going backwards and up the stairs with the head from the area just below, from the hyoid bone, from the area just below the chin, up and back up the stairs. And then you can release. And even these four movements that we've done already hold everything. But we can add Gomukhasana arms, because there's loads in Gomukhasana arms. So we can bring the right arm into internal rotation, and then bringing the back of the hand along the back and upward. I'll show you in a moment. Actually, I'll turn around so you can see straight away. And then taking your left arm up, turn the palm away. This is external rotation, and holding hands, or if you've got a belt over the left shoulder, you can hold belt. And you can hold this pose for a while. And there's also both upward and downward rotation going on here with the shoulder blades, with the scapula. And then, as you exhale, gently release, and arms can come to the side. And now the left arm internally, the humerus bone internally rotates, and the hand comes up along the spine with the palm facing away, and the right arm externally rotates, and you hold hands or belt, that now the belt is over the right shoulder. And there is downward and upward rotation of the scapula, moved by the humerus bone, so it's not by itself. And gently release. Okay. And then just feel. And simply observe the sensations in the shoulders, in the upper chest, in the neck perhaps. Feel how the circulation has increased. Simply observe your breath. And then when you're ready, you can open your eyes. I hope your shoulders feel as good as mine. Remember the magic of these sort of movements. You can even do the first four. You don't have to do all five of them. The magic of all these movements are in repeating them regularly, so that the shoulder remain, keep their flexibility. And it's not about gaining more and more flexibility. It's about functional movement, that you keep the functional movement of the shoulder, so that you can turn and twist and get things, and you know, open your bra and scratch yourself on the back without problems. So this is not about increasing super flexibility. We don't need super flexibility. We need functionality, and till we're old. So bring these into your practice, do them regularly, and enjoy them. Namaste.